One second. It's not live?
It's live. All right, Shruti Ashton, welcome to Bollywood Hangama on Facebook.
Thank you.
3 days to go for Bayan Hogi Tere. Excited or nervous?
So excited. I can't even tell you how excited I am about this film. I think this is a film that people will really, really enjoy.
Now, Bayan Hogi Tere talks about a very typical Indian guy problem called thighs only. We have seen a lot of films about friends only. For the first time, we have a film about thighs only.
Right.
This is a small town India problem.
Of course, it's a very relevant problem and it very much exists. And there are a lot of people who go through this. Yeah. And so I think this film has addressed that.
Okay. And you have a new poster, Rajkumar Rao, a very critically acclaimed actor.
Of course.
Letting
yeah.
you lay down for the first time, it seems. And,
I think comedy is one of the most difficult things to do. And I think he says that as well. And I just feel. 1 minute, you guys? Sorry. I think that, so he's a fantastic actor and I think he's been amazing on this film. And I'm really, really glad that I got to work with him.
The location and everything was, it's kind of a Delhi-ish, so, no.
Sorry?
It's the Delhi.
It's Lucknow.
Oh, it's Lucknow, really sorry.
No worries.
So, was there any problem of that accent or you had to take some that Lucknowi accent?
No, the director helped me a lot with this because this character is actually based on his sister's life. So Binni is his sister, this is her story, this is her love story, this is her, this is someone he's seen, this is a slice of his life as well. So I got a lot of help and support from him, yeah.
Okay. Tell us about your character in the film alongside working with Rajkumar Rao.
Binni is a very, she's a girl that I feel everybody will feel ki haan, hamare ghar mein bhi Binni hai. She's a girl that many people can relate to, either that they feel they have traces of Binni in them, or that they know a Binni. So she's a mix of many traits. She's vulnerable, but she's tough. She's boisterous, but she's feminine. She's romantic, but she's practical. So she's a beautiful mix of many things. So it was truly wonderful to play this character.
Would it be right to say that maybe for the first time after Amaya Vastavya, you're playing a little more like a straightforward, very girl next door kind of a role?
She's not straightforward. I mean, but she is your girl. She is typically even more than Ramaya Vastavaya. I'd say Ramaya Vastavaya still had its elements of glamour, or I don't know, I don't even think it's glamorousness, but it was just a different vibe. In this film, I've used practically no makeup. The costumes are very realistic. When I was walking around, I realized about 2 or 3 times that I was dressed like a couple of people who were there. Because we shot in somebody's house, we shot in a real life location in Lucknow, and I was really happy to see that my clothes were a lot like the girls that were walking around.
Speaking of clothes and makeup, we saw you at the GP Awards 2 days back, and I must say that dress was beautiful and it's
Thank
really
you.
Making the internet.
Thank you.
Expected so much love coming the way for that.
I'm really happy, you know, I dress up because I like dressing up. I'm not really into brands or fashion. I have a wonderful team that we come up with stuff which we think would be fun and exciting. And we're really glad when people like it, yes.
But, you know, off late, like, you know, even if you see your appearance in Cannes, or, you know, you're in this wonderful outfit you're wearing right now, there's a certain fashionista style.
Is there?
It's wonderful. It's there.
Okay.
You know, versus maybe 2 years back, it wasn't really out there. But now I think, as
you know, when I first started out, it was more like, you know, rock and roll style and much more related to my music.
Yeah.
And then as I've, you know, grown older and now I'm a bit more experimental as well. And plus it's just, you know, a lot of the stuff we wear is brought to us by our stylists. So it's up to them doing that as well. Like giving us
something uniqueness in it. Like when you follow your Instagram account, all your dresses or your whatever your pose and all that, you create your own style. You create your own
Thank
style.
You. I appreciate that. I'm not trying to be fashionable. I think there are people in this business who are 100 times more obsessed with fashion and 100 times better at it than me. I do it because it's fun. I treat it like, you know, a girl who's going to college or something and is like, today I feel like dressing up, you know. And I try to keep it as close to my personality as possible because the one thing I'm very bad at is pretending unless I'm paid for it.
So I've attended those concerts with Hero and HRC back in the day.
Oh, thanks.
So would you say that part of you, like, it's history? Like
no, not at all.
Biker chick, rock chick kind of
a... No, there's always a little grungy baby stuck inside of me. But it changes with time. My music has changed so much with time. So, yeah, things change.
So, like, what's happening on your... Because we all know you have your rock band, The Experimental.
Not anymore. Not for many years now, actually. Yeah.
So, that's where I wanted to know, like, you know, because... People on social media are really fascinated about, like, you know, when Shruti is going to do a live gig, especially in the cities like Delhi, Bangalore, Mumbai.
Yeah.
So they are waiting for it. So, like,
soon, yeah. I promise.
So
you
this
know,
year is going to be. Like,
I hope so. I mean, wow. Well, we're already in June. So yeah, yes,
yeah,
this
half
year.
Half.
I still have 6 months, but I feel that, you know, films kind of have this ability to take over everything. And I was doing at one point like 7 films at a time. It was very difficult to sit down and like kind of write music. So, I mean, I was writing it, but to kind of put it and string it together. But I am. It's something I miss very much. And I've become much more selective about my films. I don't want to be like factory producing films. I want to do the things that I love, which also allow me the time to do other things that I love, like music. Yeah.
Rajkumar Rao is not associated with romantic movies as such.
Poor film. Guy.
So, it's like, you know, it's a rom-com film.
Yes.
If you want to rate Rajkumar Rao out of 5 in terms of romance, how much would you like to
rate? I'd give him a 4.9.
Okay.
Yeah.
0.1 is like, running
I'd definitely give him a 4.9. Yeah.
Is that something to do with, like, say, okay, you can't help notice...
No, because I just can't be so partial, na? That's why.
I can't help notice the background. I see a lot of Marvel and DC. Yeah. No, predominantly DC, my mistake.
Yeah.
I see Superman, Batman, Supergirl, and it is Wonder Woman season, of course.
Like, yes. Have I seen it? No, I haven't seen it, but I heard it's amazing, so...
Yeah, and you're wearing a golden dress right now, so you would...
So, given a chance, which superhero, like, would you like to...
Oh, God, I've always loved Catwoman, but I don't know if I want to play her. I really love this character, which was actually in the Batman movie, Ra's al Ghul's daughter, Talia Ra's al Ghul. Yeah.
Okay, you're the luckiest one to have 3 actors in your movie, okay? Like Gautam Gulati, Rajkumar and other. Whom do you find the...
Very lucky, isko naam yaad nahi hai, main bahut lucky, but main badi lucky hoon, haan.
So, whom do you find...
Harry.
Harry.
Yeah.
Right. I'm so sorry. Gautam Gulati, Rajkumar Rao, and Harry. Whom do you find the cutest one amongst...
Gautam. Yeah. He's his hair is perfect. He works out. He's
okay,
he's very like... Yeah.
In the beginning of the trailer, we have seen that you dye Rakhi in... Jo bhi ladka milta Rakhi tum baanthe
ho.
Ji. So, in reality, if we are amongst Bollywood actors, aap kisko Rakhi banana?
I already have a Rakhi brother, Imran. He's my Rakhi brother. Yeah.
Any other Bollywood
actor? No, why? One is enough.
That is Imran Khan.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Okay, so I have to talk about your sister, Akshara.
Yes.
You and Akshara both are like famous for having gorgeous eyes.
Thank you. And but hers are like unreal. Yeah. Hers are like from another planet.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, tell us something about Akshara which is different from...
Oh, but very, very, very different.
In terms of movies, we all know it. Like.
No, even in personalities.
Oh, yeah.
I think the only thing in common between her and me is we're both kind of pagal. And we have the similar sense of humor. But other than that, no, we're completely different. We're like chalk and cheese. She's much more like... She's more well-mannered than me. But I'm more, I think, straight-speaking than her. I think she's definitely more patient than I am. Yeah.
So the general perception out there when she began as the first film that goes out is that she is more likely to lean towards the more serious cinema, and there is you somehow have managed to balance both sides. You're like big on mainstream.
Well, you know, she's just started out.
Also.
Yeah, no, I mean, she's just started out, so I wouldn't like encourage like boxing her up into any place, because she's still like figuring out. You never know. I mean, see, like, look, for example, today Raj, nobody expected him to do a romantic comedy, and as an actor, you have the freedom and you have a duty to try as much as you can. Yeah.
But do you think it gets tougher with every new happened debuting, like where you already step into famous shoes of your father, the legendary Gavaskar.
No, I mean,
she has to live up to two identities.
Well, she'd be the best person to answer this question, but I feel like when I came in, I wasn't like, oh my god. Of course I knew whose daughter I was. My parents are both respected actors, but they're not acting. I'm doing it. It's my work. I'll make mistakes, I'll do the right things, and I'll learn. And I think she has the same approach.
And you're collaborating with your father on the
Yes.
Tell us something about.
Well, we still have some shooting left, but it's been an amazing experience. It's a fun-filled entertainer, comedy again. And we really wanted to come out with something positive and sunshine, you know, for our first outing together.
So it was their first movie when
Yes.
Pal and daughter collaborated? So
no, actually we collaborated as with him as a producer and me as a music composer.
Okay.
Directed by somebody else.
Oh, yeah.
But this is the first time as actors. Yeah.
And due to, of course, unfortunate circumstances, he had to take over the directorial reins of this
Yes,
movie.
Yes.
So at some point, was it a way for you to also kind of step in and bond professionally more?
Yeah, probably. I mean, it was very unfortunate what happened. But he took over, and how? I mean, he really, I don't know too many people who can in 3 days take over directing a film. And he did a great, fantastic job of it, in the sense that he was also producing the film. So now when I see people saying like, you know, mera itna kaam hai, I'm like, yeah, no. You know, because I've seen how much work he's put in. So I felt really, really happy to be directed under his directorial work as well, because that changed my performance completely. And what I found most beautiful about him as a director is, having been an actor for so long, he knows exactly how to work with actors, and he somehow is able to bring out things. Yeah. And it's not, he doesn't say, aise karo, das baar karo. He watches you to see what is your strength and just spins it on that. Works with what you already have.
That's why I wanted to ask you, like, was there a between the breaks or something, like, dad used to come and give you some advice or something?
It was so busy. Between breaks, he was running around saying, what's the next shot?
Oh.
Yeah.
So, your dad, of course, is famous for having a very, he's got his very own unique directorial voice. People may agree with it, not agree
Yes.
with him, but he's very clear about how he wants his film.
He has a vision always.
So, as a performer, not as a daughter, as a performer, sometimes, did it get you like, hey, I want to do X, but what is this? Like, he's pushing me into that direction.
Never. Because he's so clear about his vision, you're on board because it's logical. It's a practical, logical decision, first. Second of all, it flows into the script he's written. And every character has a graph and a flow. And if you feel you're going against the tide, sometimes you have to. But sometimes it happens for not the right reasons. You can feel a jolt or a jerk. Nothing of the sort.
So when we step into this house, you know, there's a little bit of comics, there is music, there's a bit of fashion. We saw you helping in the kitchen as well. There's a fantastic almost makeup studio out there. I think it's kind of a microcosm of Shruti Hasan's, you know, rounded personality. Like, so what is it like? What is it a reflection of the things?
Of course,
like?
It's my home, so it'll have the things I like. And it's the place I spend a lot of time in when I'm not working, actually all the time in when I'm not working. So I like it to reflect my personality.
You're
yeah.
working all the time because we have seen you. You're pretty much active on
social
yeah. media when it comes to Instagram,
yeah.
when it comes to Twitter. How do you manage all this?
I love working. I love staying busy. I love having my breaks as well. But truth be told, when I take too long of a break, I'm a very mean person because I'm just like, I just want to work. Like, I love working. I think working gives me a lot of peace.
Janu Meri Jaan has given a massive hit. Like, it's like, you know, it's an addition to the playlist.
Yes.
It's a recreation song as well. Would you like to share an experience about that?
It's lovely. You know, I've always loved old Hindi music. I grew up with that in my home because of my mum. And Janu Meri Jaan is a beautiful song. And I'm glad that there may be a whole new bunch of years that haven't heard it, that now get to hear it because it's refixed.
Right.
And you know, and it's.
And we have seen your energy as well. It was terrific.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Would you like to sing that song?
Chano meri jaan, main tujh pe kurban. And the rest is all the guys. So I'm not going to sing that.
Talking about music, you know, you have started from a pretty young age by singing from your father's film, Heyram.
No.
Oh, okay.
Chachi Darzo.
No.
Then? Okay, the internet is wrong then.
Being dead,
no, the internet is not wrong.
No, don't read it. Don't believe everything on the internet.
My first... song
composed by Ilaiyaraaja.
Yes.
Yeah, don't believe anyone on
Did Ilaiyaraaja do the music for Chachi Charsubis? No. So, my first film that I sang for was when I was 5 years old. I sang for Tevar Magan, which was the original version of Virasat.
Yeah. So, you started from there, and then, you know, you're getting to this point where you get Filmfare nominations for the movie Puli.
Yeah.
So, how has been the whole musical journey from that point to this point?
I mean, I love Filmfare, but I wasn't working for a Filmfare nomination as a vocalist. But I'm happy for the appreciation. It's been beautiful. Music has actually predominantly been the driving force in my life. It's the first thing I knew I enjoyed doing. I didn't know if I was good. I don't think as a child you understand if you're good at something or bad at something. You do it because you like it. So like when I was a kid, it was singing, writing, painting and sports. And I just used to do it for... just because it made me happy, you know. So I'm happy that I could continue till this day in my life to do something that gives me so much personal joy and satisfaction.
So the song which I was talking about for the from the movie Puli was
Yendi Yendi.
So would you like to sing it for your live audience, a little bit of it?
I've forgotten the lyric.
It's okay. Or for that matter, any of your favorite Tamil songs which you want to sing?
Wait, I'll think. Next question.
Okay.
So the next question is, I'm going to come back to the fashion aspect. So while the entire video was focused on Deepika and Aishwarya's appearance, you kind of have data to prove on our side. Like, We have data. You quietly went to Cannes without the noise and just came out and like just slayed.
Thank you.
How was the experience? So you've spoken why the film is not happening and you won't go into that thing.
I really like you.
This is the overall experience.
The whole team is happy now.
It was lovely.
That's actually the headline. While everyone's focused on the other two women, Shruti has been quietly played at Cannes.
Oh, thank you. Well, it was actually quietly because we weren't like thinking, let's go there and show them, you know. Like, you know, like put the shoulder pad down and kill him. You know, we weren't doing that. We were just having fun. We were a team who decided, let's do something and different and fun and explore our options. So we always take what we do seriously, but we take the whole thing lightly and enjoy it because that's when there's a certain element of ease and positivity that enters anything. So also, I know that there are people who like plan their clothes well in advance and their looks. And they do tests and they figure out what works and what... We didn't do any of that. We did it there. Yeah. We like decided, no, this... It was like, you know when you're going to a party and you're like, does this really fit me well or is... And we did it like the night before. So we're really happy that people have liked it because...
That outfit by the balcony, especially when you're looking out of
the hotel
room. Oh! That selfie of yours that like...
Thank
really
you.
Awesome Bollywood Hangama. It really did.
Thank you. Really thank did. You.